These 10 players are off on an adventure, working together to pass a series of tests.
Each test they pass adds money to a group pot that only one player will win.
But one of the 10 players is a mole, a double agent, working for us to sabotage the group's efforts. Every few days, there's a quiz about the mole.
The player who scores the lowest on the quiz must leave the game immediately.
It is a simple game. Be observant, expose the mole, claim the money.
Previously on The Mole.
Jim and I had a little coalition going.
I wouldn't characterize it as a conspiracy, more along the lines of a pooling of resources for a mutual benefit.
Well, last night the rules of the game were broken. Stephen, Catherine, you were found in Jim's room in a surprise bed check.
We're the three closest friends in the group. Charlie calls it the unholy trinity.
I pointed to him for Charlie and Charlie ignored him.
You don't know what the hell you're talking about.
If I were to go and he were to stay in, it would just make me sad.
Kate. It's really been a pleasure meeting you.
I enjoyed it thoroughly. Say goodbye to everybody.
I will.
10 strangers playing for up to $1 million. Among them, a saboteur, a traitor, the mole. The winner, the one who answers the question, who is the mole? Went home, green hair and all. The mole has no mercy. And then there were four. Charlie, Jim, Catherine, and Stephen, each with the brains and background for sabotage. Only one is sure to reach the finish. That one is the mole.
The remaining people are 28, 29, and 30. You know, younger than three out of my four children.
We're always trying to kind of say goodbye, because you never know when there'll be an execution and if you'll be going or they'll be going. So I feel like I've said goodbye to Steve and Jim about a million times. I think they're tired of me saying it, frankly.
Is it ethical, really, in the long run to be tricking these people? You know, you kind of think about it and you know it's a game and it's not real, but how far do you take it?
What if Steve's tricking you? What if, what if? What if the clouds come down and attack the Earth? What if? Play the game.
Congratulations on making it this far. 10 of you started out in the game. It's now down to you four. I need you guys to divide up into two groups of two. I need two of you who are the most artistic, and two of you who can count to at least 751.
I am the arty one.
You are arty.
He's the arty one.
How about Steve and I stay together?
Whatever. You guys want to be arty?
Well, let's be...
No, we're not being arty.
All right, we're arty, and these are the counties.
All right. Counties.
Is that okay with you?
I'd like to count.
I'm not artistic.
I'm not artistic.
Being a lawyer is creative.
It is.
Whatever.
All right, I'm gonna need a decision.
Okay.
Okay.
This is it.
Jim and Catherine, you're the artistic ones. Stephen and Charlie, you will be the counters. Artistic ones, please come with me. Counters, stay here.
I'm a terrible artist, but I didn't want to say that in front of everyone else.
Why did you pick this group? You're cut.
I'm kidding.
Okay.
Between our two fingers, or two hands, with all our fingers, we can count to 20 at least. Using our toes, we're up to 40, so we feel very confident.
Look at all of those sheep. You know how many sheep could be there?
We have to herd sheep.
10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70.
There's a dog spooking them.
180, 190.
Maybe Steve knows Charlie's the mole, and Steve's playing me. Or is Steve the mole? Hopefully, it's me and Steve against the mole.
If it is Charlie, there goes the unholy trinity.
I know.
They basically talk to each other very, very frequently and have every opportunity to discuss things. I refer to them openly in front of them as the unholy trinity because they are together quite often.
Who would you be? Well, I'm not going to ask you that.
What?
Who do you want to go be, your Steve?
While Catherine and Jim head to their next destination, Charlie and Steven begin their test. They have to herd all the sheep into the corral. If they do, they'll earn $20,000 for the pot. They can earn an additional $10,000 if they can count all the sheep. To help herd the sheep, Stephen and Charlie are allowed to choose from one of three dogs, a German Shepherd, an English Sheepdog, or a Brown Mutt. Only one dog is trained at herding sheep. The other two are basically useless.
We'll go for the little brown guy.
We picked this dog because Sheepdog is not traditionally used as a sheepdog, and German Shepherds, I've never seen a German Shepherd be used to any sort of herding. Most of them are a smaller, healer-style dog or a
miniature collies.
So we just picked him.
They picked the wrong dog. The right dog was actually the German Shepherd.
We're going to teach this dog to be a sheepdog. You watch.
Little brown dog, you're going to be my hero today. I can feel it. We have 2 hours to do this. What's our time for?
1 hour.
1 hour?
It's only a game.
You're feeling very artistic?
Oh, yeah.
Right here?
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
This is not art.
I kind of like that one.
751.
Done.
No.
What we thought for this test is we thought we'd have some fun. We're now going to give you an opportunity to create your own very unique and individual piece of conceptual art.
Catherine and Jim's test is to make a work of art that'll be displayed in this art gallery. Tonight, an art critic will visit the gallery to try to figure out which piece is theirs. To pass the test, Jim and Catherine have to fool the art critic. If the critic picks out the piece they created, they fail the test. If the critic picks another piece, they earn $20,000 for the pot.
Have you ever created artwork before?
Not for a renowned art critic.
They're a bunch of phony balonies anyway.
We'll just take one or two sheep and sort of slowly guide them that way. I'll walk around the far way if you just sort of want to wait for me to get in position a little bit. You know what I'm saying? And then we'll just slowly take them that way.
I'm going to go over here, right?
Yeah, but don't push him too far.
No, I'm not going to push him at all. I'm going to try to identify the one with the bell, that's all.
Okay. We really had no strategy other than just be slow and cautious and not trying to run and spook him in a thousand different directions.
Hey,
don't move. Let me see if I can get him going this way. Charlie! I was a little bit frustrated because he was trying to do one thing and I was trying to do another.
Hey, Chai!
Hoochie? I don't know what that is. I know what a hoochie is, but I don't know how it applies to sheep. I guess he said he got it from the sheep herder. And he kept using it. I don't know if it did anything.
Hey, Jay!
Either a theme of something that's...
Jim and Catherine have an entire art studio at their disposal with all kinds of materials for creating art. But like all great artists, they first need a concept.
Maybe if we could get some kind of cardboard or something to lay it on.
Mm-hmm. What's the thought behind the box?
Box is a trap. Box is hidden. Box
there's
is
so
box.
Many,
don't you see me?
I think it was Jim who said, box is box.
Can the players create art in 3 hours?
That's too much.
You ready? Genius! Hitcha!
While Stephen and Charlie struggle with the sheep, our wannabe artists get down to work. When they finish their piece, they'll put it in the gallery.
Like a man, like, climbing out of the box?
To me, it speaks of desperation.
Exactly. The clawing.
Good. It was actually more your desperation.
Oh. What do you know about the mole?
You're saying the mole.
Yes.
Charlie. Very interesting.
Let's leave this standing alone on its own. You have something replacing the leg.
I've heard Picasso found much of his materials in the city dump.
In the dump.
Is that right?
So I've heard.
I just stacked the face mask and books on it, holding up the chair.
That's kind of cool. It's like using your identity and learning as balance.
We could pick out a leader, we'd grab him by the ears and pull him.
There's one with a bell.
We saw some sheep with bells, and Judas sheep that would lead them into the pen. I tried to kind of corral one, and that kind of spooked them.
Don't, Charlie, they're gonna run everywhere.
But I think if we get one with the bell, he'll lead them in.
Yes, but there's four of them with bells.
This is the worst of our pieces so far. I'm not liking this.
You only need to have one piece for the exhibition.
I know, but we're trying to have options so that
fine.
We can have something to choose from.
Building an oeuvre. I commend you.
I want to put our heads together on this glass, because
yes.
I think it could be cool. You know, there could be pages, you know?
It carries so much more weight.
What's the title?
You know what I mean? So it's the same as broken and so shattered. Mm-hmm. What are you thinking of this?
It's all right. But I think I like the box better.
Well, this is kind of fruity, so it could fit. Hiche.
Charlie, I'm gonna scare him this way, see if he gets his leaders in the right in front.
Hiche. Call your cousins over there. Cousins, come on over.
As soon as we get him in, let's shut that gate for a moment. Figure out how to get these last ones.
I'm gonna go try to put them over here with that Hiche bit.
Okay.
You try to just make sure he's gonna get out.
All right.
Hiche. Close them gates! Okay, go to sleep. We're gonna count you now.
I think it's getting to be too much, too many
yes.
different objects.
Less is more.
Take the head away. Let me see what it looks like without the head.
Yeah, maybe we could put the head in the box to make it more subtle.
I think this is it. We do.
So this is it?
We're not sure yet. Don't rush us.
Don't rush us. We have to make a decision on this. I vote no on the jewels.
Sometimes you just don't know when to stop.
Make your case for the jewels, and I'll make my case for the
jewels. Okay, my main case is that I think there should be something that is being reached for here. I like that it's just like crappy, broken material goods, because it just makes this whole thing seem even more futile.
They don't necessarily fit with the feel of everything else.
See, that's why I like it. I like the contrast. Mm-hmm.
You're saying yes or no on the jewels?
I know you really like them, so we're gonna go with them.
But I hate them, that's the whole
thing. You know, I did the box, she did the gloves, I did the rope. It was just like, put the jewels there. You have to, you know, have the thing that you really want in there too.
Genius!
If we win, this is gonna be the best.
Now that the sheep are in the corral, Stephen and Charlie can try to count them.
Just start counting out numbers, I guess, for you.
Yep.
It's not gonna work this way.
No matter how many sheep.
No comprendo.
Come on, you're fooling me, no?
Comprendo.
You're not fooling me? Doggy, come over here, what do you know? I can ask, he just can't tell me. Now that we got them in, we got our 20,000. If they get out again?
If they get out again, we don't get it.
I say stick with the 20. We're never gonna be able to count all these in 20 minutes anyway.
25, yeah.
If we start counting and they get through the fence, we lose 20 grand. So a bird in the hand or a sheep in the corral is worth two in the bush. I think we cut our losses and let them count themselves. Little Bo Peep, I'm not. And the time is over.
Way to go. I'm very, very satisfied and happy.
I'm happy with
I'm
that.
I'm sure the other team should be happy also.
Mark of them all.
Jim and Catherine's art is now installed in the gallery. They wait upstairs, listening while the art critic tries to pick out their piece.
Yeah, I thought we'd start by just maybe walking around and have you talk about the work a little bit.
This piece seems to sum up the whole show, doesn't it? Like, what, who, and where. Here I can see somebody is trying to make a final work. It's like a painting. It's vertical on the wall, and it's flat. All right, now let's go to this one. Nice box. I can't help thinking this could be the same artist because of the use of rope. Here we got Fighting Back, I suppose. I like it when art uses sport. This seems to be a very religious piece. It's a cross or a crucifixion. Again, I think it's too simple for it to be, you know, the non-professional piece. Non-professional always tend to do too much to start with. You put too much in. You know, you try and cover all the bases. You know? So now I've got to make up my mind, right?
You have plenty of time.
I'm suddenly thinking about this one because it is so absolutely flat. But I'm sure they'd have done more, they'd have tried harder. I think I'd go for this, actually.
So this is your selection?
I think I would go for that, because I think it's the most active piece. The others are very internal.
Well, congratulations, you guessed correctly.
Really?
Yes, you did. Jim, Catherine, you guys want to come down here?
Hi, how are you?
Well done.
Yes,
this is Jim. This is Catherine.
Hello.
That's,
hi.
Don't step on this person. Cool.
There was big debate among the afternoon artists over whether or not to include the jewelry.
Oh, no, I'm glad you did. There was also a giveaway because I said that, you know, starters will put in lots of elements.
Thanks.
But I really like it.
You shouldn't have put it in there.
Unfortunately, it was a loss for our players, but a victory for art, I think.
Probably. I suppose so. I don't know. I think this is a really nice piece.
Lorna, thank you so much for coming.
Thank
really
I enjoyed it.
Right.
That was great. Well done.
Going into the test, I kind of made light of you know, the whole kind of artistic process. But, you know, I'll admit that, you know, I had a good time doing it, and I got into it.
We have some other critics who would like to view your works, if you guys would go back upstairs. Come on in. Don't worry, it's just art.
Okay, that's art, all right.
Funky art.
I know you guys probably don't spend too much time in art galleries, but this is where Jim and Catherine spent a lot of today. Now, for their test, they had to create an original piece of conceptual art. We gave them about 3 hours to do it in. We gave them lots of supplies and a studio to work in. The piece has now been installed in this room. I want you to take some time, look around at all the 9 pieces of art in here, and if you can decide which is the one that Jim and Catherine produced, $20,000 will be added to the group pot.
We're on a roll today, so I think we feel very confident, don't we, Steve?
Come on. Yeah, we can try.
All right, well, this is your chance to be art critic, so
okay.
Have fun.
Okay,
this would definitely not be Catherine because anything with pugilistic overtones would not be her. This is kind of fruity, so it could fit.
Those things don't really bother me, but at the time I wanted to run downstairs and Catherine was there just like, oh, you're gonna make us lose, stay.
Jim jumps out at me here. Yeah. As of Catherine's input, I don't know. This look familiar?
Yeah, but that's not his. I mean, that was...
Oh, I'm sorry.
He broke it.
Uh-oh. I was allowed to touch this.
It looks like somebody drew that, and I don't think he'd even have that much talent. Let's flip for it.
Okay, heads noose.
Tails.
Red.
Okay. That's heads.
Head noose.
Noose.
Jim, Catherine, will you come down?
I heard that.
I didn't know you were there, Jim. I'm sorry. I didn't know you were there. You know, that was a, you know.
It was the bread.
You're kidding. It was not. It was not.
It's here. I collect antique sporting equipment.
Charlie.
When we were looking for a hint as to which one it would be, I found it was ironic that Charlie's name was boom right on the front of the glove, right in front of us, and neither of us saw it. I couldn't believe it.
I don't know how we missed it, Steve.
The art test is over, but the sheep test is not. They now have a chance to guess how many sheep they corralled.
You are allowed to guess, and you haven't given a figure yet.
No one has guessed it.
If you guess it correctly, that will be worth $10,000. Okay, what is the number?
Steve?
We're gonna guess at 417.
417, and you got that by?
By segmented guessing.
I'm sorry, that's not the correct number.
671.
751.
751.
Which, if you'll remember this morning, two of you who are the most artistic, and two of you who can count to at least 751.
In that moment, I was thinking, like, dummies, duh, what did they ask you in the beginning? 751. I'm not even quite sure Charlie even remembered the number.
The next test is all about trust.
Okay, I can hear knives being thrown.
I know.
It is 10 after 1 in the morning. We are cutting Jim's hair because it's been far too long since he had a haircut, so we've all gathered here together. It's a whole new Jim.
You can trim that one.
We can try to take it off.
You can just trim that like that. How about like around all like the gorilla hair kind of
like that? Like really just like shave it off?
Don't really go, don't go into the hairline at all.
I'm sorry.
You do that like right after I said it.
In the nearby town of Rhonda, also known as the Dreamed City, Catherine, Jim, Stephen, and Charlie are given the morning off to relax and window shop.
You start to think that you're making a friend, so I let my guard down. And the right people, the people who know how to play on that, too. I can't trust anyone here. At night, when I'm trying to go to sleep, I have strategy going in my head. Should I do this? Should I do that? What did it mean that Steve said this? What did it mean that Jim said that? But I just want to trust someone. I want to have that for a few minutes.
Jim definitely could have a coalition or conspiracy with somebody else. I promised him I would work with him and I wouldn't betray him.
The players are much more sensitive to discussions between two people that are off to the side. People seem to get a little stressed or annoyed about that.
Hey everyone, come on up. It's nice to see you. Gather around. Well, it is time for another test. Now, so far there's $430,000 in the group pot. This next test, you'll have an opportunity to earn a lot more. Before we begin, I need each of you to make a list. The top of the list, the player you would most like to see executed. The bottom of the list, the player you would most like to see remain in the game. Why don't you go back down the stairs, separate, make up your list, and when you're finished, take your list and place it in that vase. Good luck.
The four players are faced with a tough decision. Who would they like to see executed, and in what order? That's information they may not want to reveal, because they're afraid it might just be used against them.
You made your list. I've had a look at all of them. Now, I'm not going to let you know the name of the person you would most like to see executed. In fact, I'm really not interested in that. What I am interested in is the name of the person you would most like to see remain in the game. That person is going to play a very important role in this next test, because this next test is all about trust, and you're going to have to trust that person. The name of the person you most want to see remain in the game is Steven. So, Steven, you're going to come with me. The rest of you are going to stay here. And you'll find out soon enough what the test is all about. Steven, let's go back down.
Just a step.
This next test is all about trust. You're gonna have to convince the three other players to undertake three assignments which are either very risky or appear very risky. It's gonna be up to you to convince them to undertake those assignments. Now, this test is very valuable. It's worth $60,000 for the group pot. More importantly, for you, it's worth an exemption. You can understand how important an exemption would be at this point.
An exemption would mean Steven could not be executed and would automatically make it to the final round.
Now, as I said, the assignments are all quite dangerous. The first one is you have to convince one of the players to stand against a board and have a professional knife thrower throw a knife at them. Second assignment, you have to convince a player to walk over a bed of hot coals blindfolded. Third assignment, you have to convince a player to walk out on a plank blindfolded
over a 100-foot ravine.
So you have to decide which player is going to do what task.
All the players are told how important this test is.
Steve is going to ask each of us to do something. And if each of us does that thing, then we win $60,000 and Steve gets an exemption.
Two of us do it, we earn the money. But no exemption for Steve.
If one of us performs it, we'll get no money, but that individual who performs it will get an exemption in the next quiz.
If none of us will do what he asks, however, we get no money and Steve gets an exemption.
An exemption is key, which kind of makes this kind of difficult.
Who do you want for the knife throw?
I'll put Catherine on the knife throw.
Okay. For the hot coals?
I will put Jim on the hot coals and then Charlie on the plank.
All right. See how you do. Good luck.
We'll see. Do you remember one of those stories you told about Mr.
Yes.
Okay, that's Will.
Okay, I can hear knives being thrown in the background.
Hang on. Okay.
great. I was stupid then.
I know. Well,
I can't do it. I can't do it.
You cannot do it at all?
Have knives thrown at me?
I'm going to tell you what's going on, all right? Because I can see your face is going a little red here, okay? What I'm asking you to do is I just want you to stand very still, and he's going to throw one time, okay? Will you do that? And I've seen him throw.
Why can't I see him throw it?
They won't let you see him throw it. But would you do that for me?
I don't think I can do it.
Well, listen, I chose you specifically for this task.
Why would you do that? Okay. What are the other tasks? Give me the different one.
I cannot tell you.
I don't want to do it.
I would imagine it's going to be something that's going to look real hairy and, you know, put you on the brink of death.
Walk over here with me.
I put your stupid name on that stupid sheet and you pick me for this?
Well, I can't tell you what the other ones are, but it's just lean up against this, okay?
I can't do this.
Hey, you can do this,
I cannot do this.
Don't you trust me? I chose you for
this. I put you on there at last because I thought you were the mole, not because I trusted you. Oh, my God.
I put you on my list last too, okay?
I just have to think for a second, okay?
Okay. Just think for a second. But you have to know that you were chosen specifically for this one. Okay? Do you understand that? Okay. Take out. Are you okay? You here?
Catherine, just take it easy. You fainted. You're okay.
What is under the board?
The bridge is halfway under the board. The other half is open air.
Okay. Take it easy. Catherine, you fainted. Did you hit your head? Feeling all right?
That's embarrassing.
Just sit here for a while, relax. I'm in a rush. Want something to drink?
Mm-mm. You okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you want to stop now?
No, I can do it.
You can do it?
Do I get to tell him when to go? Okay, we'll bring him out here and then let me think about it a little bit more. Is he named Mr. by any chance? That's why Steve picked me for this. It's my fourth grade teacher. He used to throw darts at me and I let him. But I was stupid back then. I don't think I can do it. Oh my God! I thought I got to tell him when to go.
Okay, slowly it's gonna get a little steeper. Watch out if there's a rock on the side, it's a little trail. Good, high step it out. You're doing fantastic. Okay, step down. Okay, now looks like we're dancing and people are gonna kill me for this one. Whoa, careful. You hear that fire?
Yeah.
Have you ever seen fire walking?
Yeah.
That's what I'm gonna ask you to do for me. Now when we do this, we need to go just kind of quick so that your feet aren't staying stationary. What have they explained to you so far?
If three of us do it, we get the money and you get the exemption. If two of us do it, we get the money and you don't get the exemption. If only one of us does it, that one person gets the exemption. No money, but the exemption. Mm-hmm. If zero do it, you get the exemption and no money.
Okay, and just make sure those feet are staying off those coals. I need you to trust me on this one, all right?
Okay.
All right. Ready? You stay on course?
Straight this way?
Straight this way, and I'm gonna be right next to you, okay, guiding you.
Ready?
I'm ready. Let me count down to three for you. Ready? One,
two,
three. Go, 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 go. Good job! Nice! Guess which one you did?
He made me do that one.
Yeah.
Because I trusted you. Hold on, dude. That's why it wasn't too hot.
That's exactly why it wasn't hot.
So, what did you do and how'd you make out?
Well, I did it. I had to stand blindfolded in front of a door and have someone throw knives at me, which I first passed out as I was standing there waiting.
You didn't literally.
I did literally pass out.
You did?
And then, I don't know, I mean, I kept playing the figures in my head the whole time I was going over there, like, what's the best way? Should I just refuse to do it? But I was afraid, like, if I refused and then somebody else couldn't do theirs.
Jim would go for anything, to tell you the truth.
Probably.
No, if they bring Jim back here and he says, okay, you did it and he did it, we have our 60,000, right? Nobody gets an exemption. That would be the ideal situation.
Catherine and Jim both completed their tasks, adding $60,000 to the pot. If Stephen can now convince Charlie to walk the plank over this ravine, no additional money gets added to the pot, but Stephen gets the valuable exemption.
Trust me on this one, okay?
I trust you explicitly.
Okay, but this one is, I picked you out specifically for because I know you're mentally stronger than the other two, okay?
Okay.
All right. What it entails is you walk along a board, follow my directions, and walk back. That's what your task is.
How wide is the board?
The board is about 18 inches wide. Okay, can you do that blindfolded? If I can give you directions.
What is under the board?
The bridge is halfway under the board. The other half is open air. Okay?
Okay.
All righty. You trust me on this one? I'm not going to let you down.
Now I have a choice of going or not going?
That's exactly true.
Okay, now I know that Catherine has already successfully completed her portion of this test.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And if Jim completed his portion of the test.
I can't tell you what he did.
I know you can't. Okay. But if that would be the case, then it would not pay for me to go and do this because we would already have won the $60,000. And if I do go and complete this, we won't win any additional money, but we'll be giving you an exemption from the next mm-hmm. quiz.
That's exactly true.
However, on the other hand, if Jim didn't complete his portion of the test, and then I don't do it, Catherine will get an exemption.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of a bit of a dilemma.
What is that?
It's some sort of rig or something. It's.
Do you think he is bungee jumping?
I don't know if it's high enough. Well, look, I actually didn't have to walk on coals, so he probably didn't have to bungee jump.
You're a nice guy. I wouldn't want to begrudge you an exemption, but I don't think it'd be fair to the others to go out and do this just mm-hmm. to give you an exemption either.
I completely understand that.
And of course, if I'm a chicken, I can use this as an alibi.
Mm-hmm.
So, let me give it a go.
He's walking the plank, basically.
Yeah.
I want you to take your right foot, and I want you to lift it up in the air and take a slow step forward. I got you right here. We'll just go right foot leading every time, okay? Lead with the left. Excellent. That's the railing right there. A little higher. Good. Okay. Okay. Go slow here, okay? One rung at a time. Now you're at the bottom of the ladder, and there's a little support right below you. You're doing just perfect. Slowly, slowly.
Arm slightly out to the side.
Yes.
Okay, so your hat there. Go slowly. One at a time.
Tight. Okay.
I don't like the sound of that waterfall down there.
Yeah, it's just actually a small river. Arms out for balance. Your body is still going to the right a little bit, okay? Charlie got 6 inches. One more shuffle and you'll feel something right there. Stop.
See, he's doing it.
He's doing it.
I want you to make a slow turn, okay? You're right directly in the center of the board right now, okay? Rotate your hips. Okay, with your right foot follow. Excellent. A little bit further and you're almost at a 90. Couldn't do it better. Good. Just go really slow like that and you'll be there. Okay?
Getting shaky.
Okay. You're about a third of the way. You're almost home. You're at the home stretch right now.
And you're very close.
You're doing excellent, Charlie. Arms out for balance. Shuffle forward and you're very close. You're almost there, okay? Keep going. Okay, Charlie, I want you to reach straight out in front of you now. And then move your left hand down. There you go. Right there, that's the first rung.
So all
you have to do is get over this ladder and you're done. Just slowly bring your other foot around the ladder. You're almost there. And we'll be done.
Piece of cake.
That was nothing.
Excellent job, Charlie. Great job. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Job.
Just to be blindfolded and walking around is like eerie, and you just have to put yourself in the control of the person that's leading you. And I have full faith and confidence in my fellow law enforcement guy. But you know, harnesses are harnesses, but we always see that parachute that doesn't open.
Hey.
Lee.
What's up?
So, what happened to you? We know what happened to her.
We all did it, it looks like.
We all do.
Tell what it went on.
Well, you guys know the whole spiel here. Start off with Catherine. I chose her for the knife throwing because of Mr. He stood her up against the board and she fainted. At that point, I thought for sure it would be no, but she said yeah, she would do it. And nobody threw knives or anything at her. It was fake.
Oh my God!
See, I told you there was no.
I told you too. I told you it was.
Jim's was not bad. It was walking on hot coals. Only his wasn't really hot coals. His was
unburned coals.
And then Charlie came, and his was to walk this plank over here.
Charlie had said that one reason why he went ahead was to prevent me from getting an exemption on the off chance that Jim hadn't performed, and it just doesn't hold water. We knew Jim would do whatever was thrown at him. So, and Charlie knew that I had done mine. I mean, there are two possibilities that I've thought of from that. One, which terrifies me, which is that Charlie actually is the mole, or he could have given Steve the exemption because he knows that Steve's the mole.
Part of me really wanted Steve to get the exemption because we have a relationship. Because if I were in that position, I would want him to do the same for me.
The day ends with questions of trust and suspicion. The pre-execution dinner is strained and uneasy as everyone realizes that another player will be eliminated tonight.
I don't think it's any secret that Steve and I, as law enforcement officers, would like to be the last two people.
Charlie sacrificed a lot for me. He put himself in harm's way, and so did Jim. And I'm torn between the two. But the fact of the matter is that I gave my word to Jim, so I will honor that.
So have you guys all become more superstitious on this thing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm wearing my lucky rubber band.
Definitely do the knock thing all the time.
With odd numbers.
With odd numbers. And if I really...
When you knock, you have to knock with an odd number?
You have to knock with an odd number, preferably 11.
And you carry your hair with you, yes?
She started it.
He thinks I've shorn him of his mojo by cutting off his hair, and all his powers are gone now, so he has to carry it with him.
It's like Samson.
Samson and Delilah.
Tonight, either Charlie, Catherine, or Jim will be executed. As they begin the quiz, Stephen feels the burden of their trust.
Good luck, Charlie.
Thank you.
Well, essentially, the exemption puts it down to me in the finals with one other person. I must admit, I do feel a little guilty about having it. I also feel guilty about it because each one of them told me yesterday that there was nothing that they wouldn't do for me. So.
Pretty emotional about this.
Yeah, I am.
It's time for the quiz. 20 questions about the mole. The player who scores the lowest must leave the game immediately.
If I'm executed tonight, this is just a game, and if they outplay me in the game, then more power to them.
Well, I certainly hope that I will win. I'll do my best to win. I think that Jim has a distinct advantage in that he and Catherine have a very tight relationship that has developed between them.
Yeah, Charlie could be the mole. Do I think he is? No, and if he is, I'm screwed.
You know, it's hard for me to say in the sheep test what happened. I thought it was odd that neither of them came up with the accurate number of sheep because the number had been given to them.
One of the perfect games the mole could play would be to form such a tight bond, reliance, relationship with someone else, and to basically have that person in the palm of his hand.
It's just really hard for me to figure out if Jim is being played or if I'm being played.
If I had to rely on somebody or trust someone, Steve would be the one that I would rely on and trust.
I will not be beaten by Charlie.
It's gonna be tough tonight. I've met some really cool people, met some real asses, but had a great time.
I'll begin entering your names into this computer. If a red thumbprint appears, you are the mole's seventh victim.
It is now down to four players, but with Steven's exemption tonight, it's really between Catherine, Jim, and Charlie.
I know it seems like an eternity ago that we all met for the first time in the desert in California. We've all gotten to know each other very well. Early on in the game, you were each concerned about being executed in the first few rounds of the game. You've all lasted longer than anyone else, so you are each to be commended. Congratulations. I'll begin entering your names into this computer. If a red thumbprint appears after your name has been entered, you are the mole's seventh victim. Charlie, you ready?
Yes.
Jim?
Mm-hmm.
Catherine? All right, Catherine, you've indicated you'd like to go first. Jim? Charlie? Charlie, please take your bag.
Yesterday, we were standing on that bridge, and he knew what was at stake. He knew he'd give me an exemption here. I feel some guilt that he's gone because it probably should have been me.
He committed moral suicide for me.
I would have been upset, very upset, if there had been any other result.
As far as Steve and I getting together and working together, you know, I do think that I picked the right person to have a coalition with.
All I wanted was to be playing the end game with these two people right here.
I'm humbled by you guys putting me lowest on your list.
We didn't really know what we were doing.
Yeah, I know, that's the other thing. So, I
mean, don't be too humbled by it, buddy.
I have absolutely no regrets, and I'm sure my friends in law enforcement will think that I should have lasted and won the pot. But I think I'll have a good excuse. I'll tell them my detective skills are 8 years rusty, and some of these young whiz kids have sharper minds than I do now.
So unexpected.
How are you doing?
Oh, wonderful.
When I get home, I'm going to put a classified ad in local papers that sheep herd are available, dog not required.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next episode of The Mole.